Welcome to the video lecture by Dr. Vijayavardhan for the course Calculus 2 Math 112 for week 10. In this video we are going to solve some problems from the chapter 6.1 and 6.2 from your textbook. And thus we will start with the area between two curves. So the problem that we are going to discuss is finding area of the portion lying between two curves f of x and g of x. Condition is f of x is greater than g of x. So the curve f of x is lying above the curve g of x. This is g of x and this is f of x. So in the x-axis, this is between a and b. So we are supposed to find the area between these two curves. That is the topic, area between two curves. Before we are going to find the formula for finding area between two curves and the in the interval a and b, we have to recall the logic the formula that we have studied for definite integral. What is a definite integral? If there is a function f of x non-negative continuous in the interval a to b in the x-axis, isn't it? This x-axis. So how do you find the area? So this area is nothing but we divide this interval a to b into n rectangles. There are n rectangles, 1, 2, so we call the general, we take a general rectangle here whose interval length is del xk, and we take either right end or left end or mid end, midpoint, any one of this point to find the height of this rectangle, call it f of xk star. So the area of this particular strip is f of xk star times del xk. As there are n rectangles, we will sum this for n k from 1 to n, and when n is larger, infinitely larger, if this is approximating the area between a and b under the curve f of x between the points a and b, isn't it? So the same concept we are going to use here to find the formula for this problem. So here this is slightly different. This is the area below the function y is equal to f of x and above the function y equal to g of x, isn't it? So the strip height is calculated here. This is the general strip. We take the same interval length del xk, and the height of this strip has been found as f of xk star minus g of xk star, isn't it? So the area of the particular strip will be like f of xk star minus g of xk star times del xk. As there are n rectangles, we sum them from k is from 1 to n, and when n approaches infinity, this is the area. Now this is nothing but integration from a to b, f of x minus g of x into dx. So this is what we are going to do. There are two functions, f of x and g of x, and f is greater than g. The curve of f lies above the curve of g, isn't it? So that's the formula. The same formula can be interpreted in terms of y as well if the graph is given. So this is the formula actually. This is the formula that we are going to use, that we have derived right now, and you can read and understand what we have discussed right now. So the procedure has been given here. We are directly using this procedure to solve problems. I will explain the procedure when we solve the problems, right? Okay, this is the another version of the formula. So when the functions the area is bounded by two functions of y. This is x is v of y, this is x w of y, and the condition is w is greater than right side. So right side function is greater than the left side function, isn't it? W is greater than v and lying between the limits of y between c and d. So the formula here from c to d, you can write w of y, a function of y, another function of y, v of y, integrate with respect to dy. The same formula can be interpreted in terms of y, and make sure that the bigger function will be in the right side, the curve of the bigger function on the right side. Now here we go to solve some problems. Exercise set 6.1 we are in. There are many problems, and for every case we'll see at least one problem. And I think let's take this problem number one. Find the area of the shaded region. So this is the area you're looking for, the shaded area, isn't it? And now we are integrating with respect to x, our addition. There is no specification in the question, so we decide that our formula is from integral a to b, the area f of x minus g of x dx, isn't it? So f of x here, upper function, f of x is y is equal to x squared plus 1. G of x is another y in the lower function, that is y is equal to x. You can verify the values for g in the interval. See here, it is negative 1, no, upper limit is. So a is negative 1, b is 2. All information have been given, so we need to just integrate it. That's it, nothing to be found from the graph. Everything's and nothing has been left, everything has been given in the graph itself. So we have to integrate, that's it. The area is from negative 1 to positive 2. F of x minus g of x is x square plus 1 minus g of x into dx. So just integrate and substitute the upper and lower limit. You will integrate it, first term x cube over 3. The term 1 will get you x minus x square over 2 from negative 1 to 2. Now you know how to substitute upper and lower limit, get the answer, substitute and get the answer. It is 9 over 2 or 4.5 by using your calculator. And I am going to the next problem. In this case, like to solve or like to leave to you. You can do with respect to y here for this problem, isn't it? Because it's given that the right side function is this one. This is w is x is equal to 2 minus y square, and v, which is given in the left side function, which is negative y, isn't it? And the limit of y is from 0 to the intersection is appearing here, isn't it? So y is from 0 to 2. So when you write the formula of area in terms of y, it is 0 to 2. So we can write c to d f of x, it's w of y minus v of y dy. So what do you get here? Integral 0 to 2 w of y, the right side function is 2 minus y squared minus y and dy. What do you get? Integral 0 to 2 minus y squared, this is minus y, plus y dy. Integration is your task, you can do it. The integration is 2y minus y cube over 3 plus y square over 2 from 0 to 2. Substitute upper and lower limits, you will get the answer as 10 over 3. You can do it. Answers are being given. Next, to find the area of the shaded portion by part A, integrating with respect to x and integrating with respect to y. I will do one part and the rest, second part is your task. You will do it yourself, isn't it? So when you want to integrate with respect to x or y, write the appropriate formula. If you are looking for a if you are looking for integrating with respect to x, first the formula of area is case A. The formula of area is integral in the direction of x. You can see x is from 0 to 2,
x is from 0 to 2, and the upper limit is 2, upper curve is 2x and minus lower curve is x square dx. That is it. When you integrate, you will get the answer. And for the second case B, I'll give the technical part, you can solve it. B, y limit is 0 to 4, isn't it? 0 to 4, actually the area and see 0 to 4. And the right function is y is equal to x square. So what is x? X is square root of y, positive square root of y, square root y. Minus here, upper the left function is v. V is given as y is equal to 2x, so x is equal to y over 2 root y minus y over 2. Integrate this one with respect to y and substitute the limits. Thus, the task has been left to you. Okay. Sketch the region. There are some problems and we solve one by one. Sketch the region. Enclosed by the curves and find its area. There are two problems. One will be solved by me and the other one is yours. And there are totally six problems in under consideration for this title. Out of six, we will solve three right now. Okay, then you have to find 7 and 8. Which one is good for you? X cube minus 4x is good or what? So you should know how to roughly draw the graph. Let me try the problem number 7, as already discussed. Similar type problem has been discussed. It's okay. We'll go with the problem number this one. 8. Y is equal to, so this, which one is upper function, which is lower? Y is equal to 0 and between x 0 and, so it is between origin 0 and x is 0, x is 2, isn't it? So this is the limit given here, the limits of x. The formula we write, area is 0 to 2 f of x minus g of x into dx. So f of x is given here, g of x is given. Y is 0, is it? No, actually y is 0 is y is 0 is x, this line x axis. So this is y is 0. From the graph we can identify which is f of g. If it goes wrongly, you will get negative answer. So let's rewrite it. This is not f of x, this is not g of x. Y equal to 0 is this curve, and what is y is equal to x cube minus 4x. How do you find when x is 0, y is 0? Y 0 you here, when x is negative 1, some values you can give for x between 0 and 2. X is 1, you will get y is what? X is 0, y is 0, right? So find this one. When x is 0, y is 0. When x is 1, 1 cube 1 minus 4 is minus 3. So when x is 1, y is 1, 2, 3, negative 3, it is here. And when x is 2, 8 minus 8, it is 0 again. So you're coming this way and moving back to this way. So the curve is below y equal to 0. So upper function f of x is y is 0, g of x is this one. Right? Something. So this is the area we are looking for. Okay. So now write down integral 0 to 2 f of x is 0 minus x cube minus 4x and dx. Integration is quite easy. Now this is actually when you integrate, it is 4x square over 2. I'm integrating this negative and negative positive, 4x square by 2. And this is negative x raised to 4 over 4 from 0 to 2. Simplify and the answer is 2 times 2 square is 4 minus 2 raised to 4 over 4. So this is 16 over 4, 4, 8 minus 4, the answer is 4. Square units, that's it. Now let's solve a problem, a different problem, which is, there are three problems in this list. We will solve 10 right now and then think of 18. Problem number 10. How to sketch this graph, and you should have an idea about the second function. This is x-axis, this is y-axis, isn't it? And between now, let's solve this problem number 10. Y equal to secant square x. Actually, when you try secant x, the graph will be like this between. So here we are given between minus negative pi by 4 and positive pi by 4, isn't it? It will be a curve like this for secant square, between minus pi by 4 and positive pi by 4. It will go when x is 0, it will be 1. So here the distance is 1, but we are given upper another function, y is equal to 2, this is y is equal to 1, isn't it? So the integration is quite easy now here. Problem number 4, finding area, integral, the limits have been given as negative pi by 4 to positive pi by 4, the upper function is y is equal to 2, isn't it? So 2 minus secant square, the lower curve is secant square x dx. Now when you integrate this one, what do you get? Integration 2, which is 2x minus integration of secant square is tan x, and from negative pi by 4 to positive pi by 4. Which is 2 times pi by 4 minus tan pi by 4 for upper limit minus 2 times negative pi by 4 minus tan negative pi by 4. So what you get is pi by 2 minus 1 minus pi by 2 plus 1. So what you finally get is pi by 2 plus pi by 2 is pi, minus 1 is pi, minus 2 is the answer. Let's go for problem number 18, the last problem of this chapter. Problem number 18. Now let's discuss problem number 18, isn't it? Let's see the graph. The graph, roughly we will see, this is x-axis and y-axis. Y is equal to x is a 45 degree line. Y is equal to 4x, another curve we are drawing. X is equal to 1, y is equal to 4. It will go like this. X is equal to 1, y is 4, isn't it? 1, 2, 3, 4, something bigger. So this is the curve, and another one is x plus y is equal to 2. This is x plus y is equal to 2, will be a line passing through 2 and 2, this side, both sides, isn't it? This is y is equal to minus x plus 2. So you are in this triangle, the area. So here when you divide this portion to two parts, the first part of the triangle is covered, bounded by two functions. This one is y is equal to 4x and y is equal to x. The second part is bounded by two lines, y is equal to negative x plus 2 and y equal to x. So we need to find two areas. This is a1 and this is a2, and the point of intersection will give you the x value here. What is it? So this is the intersection of y equal to 4x and y equal to negative x plus 2. Can you solve them to get x? So y is equal to 4x. Y is equal to 4x intersects with the negative x plus 2. So 4x is equal to negative x plus 2, which is 5x is equal to 2. X is 2 over 5. So this is the point. We need only the x value here. So this is x value 2 over 5. This is x value 2. So this interval is 0 to 2 over 5 and then 2 over 5 to 2. So let's write the formula now. Area. Integral, first integration is 0 to 2 over 5. In this interval, the upper curve is y is equal to 4x minus the lower curve is y is equal to x dx. In the second interval, it is in the second region, it is 2 over 5 to 2. 2 over 5 to 2 over 1 x plus y is. Okay, we don't want to integrate here up to, so here the intersection of these two values should have been known. That is our upper limit. We don't want to integrate up to 2. So this is not 2. This is, we will find it. This point, that is what is x. So y is equal to x. It's negative x plus 2. So this will give you 2x is equal to 2, x is equal to 1. So this point x is 1. So this area ends at this point, not at 2. We are not looking for 2. So this is upper limit is 1 here, right? So 1. This the upper, in this interval, the upper curve is minus x plus 2 and the lower curve is y is equal to x minus x dx. So what is the answer? Area A is equal to, first one is integral, this is 3x. 3x, when integrated 3x, is 3x square divided by 2 from 0 to 2 over 5. Second one, this is minus 2x plus 2. So this is 2 will give you 2x, minus 2x square will be minus 2x will be minus 2x square over 2 from 0 2 over 5 to 1. Now substitute upper and lower limit. And that's your task. You can find the area as 3 over 5 by using calculator. That's end of this chapter. The next chapter will be answers have been given here. Next chapter will be discussed in the next video. Thank you very much.